It's kind of why you're here. For my purposes, it's definitely why you're here. I finished writing a short story about 5 or 6 days ago. And it's a fairy story. It's the first time I've done a big sort of fairy story reinvention and game and playing with one, probably since I wrote a story called Snow Glass Apples a while ago. And I wrote the story and I thought, good, that's my story written in the first draft. I wonder if it works. And I realized I had absolutely no idea. So I called Gideon and I said, Gideon, can you give me a small audience? And bless him, he said yes. And he has. And I want to thank you, Gideon, and thank everyone at Bard for giving me this glorious space and extra chairs. Need to sit down at any point. And the story, which, if you're worried about S's, is the single worst possible title, is The Sleeper's Spindle. It was the closest kingdom to the queen's, as the crow flies. But not even the crows flew it. The high mountain range that served as the border between the two kingdoms discouraged crows as much as it discouraged people, and it was considered impassable. More than one enterprising merchant on each side of the mountains had commissioned folk to hunt for the mountain pass that would, if it were there, made a rich man or woman of anyone who controlled it. The silks of Doramar would have been in Kensalair in weeks, in months, not years. But there was no such pass to be found. And so, although the two kingdoms shared a common border, nobody crossed from one kingdom to the next.